Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, I'll show you an architectural pattern that helped me to onboard Internet of Things devices at scale. Recently, while working on an IoT project to monitor warehouses, I faced the challenge of onboarding thousands of devices across different regions. Additionally, the cybersecurity requirements varied from region to region. In this case, the IoT devices were being manufactured by a third party. And to meet the requirements, they would have to ship directly from the manufacturer to the place of installation. The third-party manufacturer devices were not part of a cloud-managed public key infrastructure, meaning they did not have a unique X509 certificate trusted by AWS. Devices in this stage must receive a trusted certificate that is also signed by a trusted certificate authority that is then registered with AWS. A secure connection with TLS has three requirements: a unique device certificate in the IoT device, the certificate registered in AWS, and a certificate authority trusted by both sides. AWS IoT Core helped me to overcome this challenge. First, the third-party device manufacturer provides a certificate authority of which all device certificates have been signed during the manufacturing process, which you register to AWS IoT Core. Second, all devices then are programmed to connect to the AWS IoT Core endpoint, which has the certificate authority registered. Upon the connection, request by an unregistered device, AWS IoT Core will confirm the device certificate signature. If that matches the registered certificate authority, the device will be provisioned by one of the provisioning methods. Provisioning flows with AWS IoT Core can vary to meet different requirements. Flip provisioning, just-in-time provisioning, just-in-time registration, or your custom authentication flow. Regardless of which method, the objective of a provisioning flow is to establish trust and create cloud resources that represent the IoT device. Those resources are created based on a provisioning template, Lambda function, or a combination of both. At the end of provisioning flows, you have a registered device certificate, an IoT thing registry, and an IoT policy. Additionally, the provisioning flow can be used as a mechanism for an event-driven cloud infrastructure. AWS IoT Core is integrated with many other AWS services. That integration helped me to solve another challenge. In my use case, the application cloud resources such as the databases and EC2 instances should only be provisioned upon a new device registration. In this case, the provision event can be used to trigger calls to other services and therefore provision resources for you. Event Bridge and CloudWatch can be used to optimize those actions. Also, by using AWS IoT Device Defender and AWS IoT Device Management, your device certificate rotation and firmware updates can be scheduled and monitored, helping you with your infrastructure's cybersecurity posture and operational excellence. It is essential to take the time to plan how your device will receive the necessary certificates to interact with your cloud infrastructure. And it is important to remember, certificates are created and signed during the manufacturing of the devices. Check out the link below for more details. Thank you for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.